Hey everybody, well it seems that not just the people from here, okay? So let's go to start. I think that, well, basically not too much things to say because, well, most of us, we are aware of the new feature that we have started to implement, that is high availability for RGW proxy. We have started with somebody has write something design payers. Over now.
That's last week's design PRs thing in the
Okay, yes, I am saying I am taking a look in the path. I don't know if somebody's writing. Today is October 26. Well, I think that probably for you could be interested, Karen. We have started with the implementation of for RGW and the pull request. Is this one? I'm going to put in the other path. And also in the chat, okay? Because well, we are going to use a pull request in order to implement all the functionality. So we are going to put several commits using the same pull request. But the first one is just about augmentation, about how are we going to use the how are we going to provide this service to the final users, okay? About the command
Okay.
that it is going to be used. And explain the functionality. So, Karen, if you can take a look just to be sure that is a documentation that is easy to read and easy to understand, it will be nice. So if your feedback will be welcome.
Okay, sure thing.
And I think that okay, perfect. Something from your part, Karen?
I don't have a lot to report, but I did hear last week after the program meeting that we have our next alpha drop on November 3rd, and that's when I checked with you to see if there are changes. Since they're not, the draft documentation is already ready, and so I'll be ready to deliver that. But in the meantime, behind the scenes, I'm stealing a few minutes here and there to try and fill in the day two tasks and other things that we're doing. But we can deliver the day one stuff that we promised without me having to do any other work on it.
Okay. Well, I think this is more downstream than upstream, okay? But in any case, well, the things that I can say you is that next alpha drop, there are no changes in the installation process. So probably, I think that the documentation about this part is complete, okay? And you do not need to make any changes. And for day two operations, I suggest you to use the workflows document that we have in downstream.
Yes, definitely.
I
I'm still
think
with
this
John, just
is
writing notes.
all. Sorry?
Oh, so I'm still with you. I'm
Having
just writing
notes?
notes. Yeah, but I'm done.
Okay, but no doubts about adding notes. Do you
Oh
have
no,
any doubt about
no,
this item?
no. I'm sorry. I think you misheard me.
Okay.
But no, I keep a paper notebook because I remember things better when I write them down. So I'm writing about the pull request, and I will go and read it after this meeting.
Okay. In any case, well, just ping us, Daniel, Adam, or myself, okay? You have doubts, and I think that we can help you.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. Well, I think that for the upstream side, probably should say they are very, very busy with their new release, or they are in a party celebrating that they have a new release. Okay. But in our case, well, just to comment, we can take advantage of this meeting in order to comment the start of the HA proxy implementation. Daniel, Adam, do you have any kind of any doubt, any question about the way to follow to get the first task in order to implement?
I think I'm a little confused on how all our work's going to get put into that one PR, but I assume we'll figure that out as we go. I'm not sure if I should create my own branch on my fork of my Ceph, copy of Ceph, or if I should be cloning your branch.
No.
That was my only doubt.
You need to clone the upstream branch that I have created, okay? So I think that do you remember that I shared with you an article about how to test a pull request?
Yep, I remember that.
Okay, I think that I sent you an email, okay? And basically, this is the thing that you need to do, is to clone the upstream branch and start to work in this branch, okay? And if you have new things to add, you need to create a new commit and push the commit to the branch. And then what we are going to have is a set of cumulative commits that is going to create the whole in functionality. Do you understand? I can search for the article and send you again an email, okay? Just to you can use the strategy or the tools that are explained in the email in the article, okay? But basically is just to create a copy of a clone of the upstream branch in order to work.
All right, that works. I was just a little confused on how exactly we were going to make that all work. Yeah, if you have the article handy, or I'll try to read through by email or chat, or try to find wherever you sent it before.
Okay. Adam, have you started with any task or?
Yeah, I'm trying to do this stuff in the binary to let you deploy HA proxy. It's listed in the task list as
Okay,
create system D unit. But I feel like there's a bunch of stuff that kind of falls under that.
okay.
But I'm working on that right now.
Okay,
Yeah, so
perfect.
my plan was, what I thought I was going to do is, so I'll build something. I was going to clone the contents of your branch, and then I was going to try to make a pull request against your branch. And once I do that, if I like you and Dan can review it, and then we'd be able to merge that into that branch, and then it would appear on the upstream PR.
But the pull request is created, okay? You do not need to create a new pull request, okay?
The
The
pull
thing
request would
that you
be.
need to do is to create commits and push these commits to the pull request. And we will have only one pull request with all the commits.
What I was trying to say was, if you make a pull request against the branch that your pull request is based on, then it'll just get added to that pull request. It won't make a new one in the upstream. It'll make
Ah,
a.
okay.
That way you can review it
Okay,
first before we put it in.
yes. Very good idea. Okay, we can test with that. Okay, so very good idea. We can do the things in that way. Okay, a pull request against the branch that is opened in that moment in this moment in upstream. Okay, perfect. Very good idea. Let's try and let's see how it works, okay? Because it's something that one of the bad things of just pulling commits in the same pull request is that we are going to have a lot of information about different things in the same pull request, and I don't like that. Okay, so is that what you
thought? That way, like everybody, other people could review each thing as we do it, and that way we know what's going on better than just a commit getting at it.
Perfect. Perfect. Okay. So let's go to work in that way. Okay. And I think that probably it will be the right way to do the things. Okay. So perfect. Okay. Any other thing? No, but I think that this is all for today. I will update the upstream document and see you tomorrow, okay?
Okay, great.
Goodbye.
Good day. Bye.
Bye. Bye.